Welcome to AATCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we are discussing about QRS complexes in ECG. QRS complex represents the ventricular depolarization. QRS complex starts just before ventricular contraction. It represents ventricular depolarization. It is important to understand that not every QRS complex will contain Q, R or S waves. Some QRS will have only RS, some QRS will have only QS. So QRS complex doesn't mean that all these three waves are present. Under normal circumstances, the duration of the QRS complex will be between 0.06 to 0.12 seconds. The QRS complex is usually positive in lead 1 AVL, V5, V6 and 2, 3 AVF. The QRS complex is usually negative in AVR, V1, V2. Why it is negative in AVR is the current travels away from the vector of right side. Right side vector is connected on the right upper limb. The current is traveling away from this vector. So all the QRS complexes in AVR will be usually negative. Now normal width of the, we have to understand first what is the normal width of the QRS complex. Normal width of the QRS complex is less than 120 milliseconds or 3 small squares. Remember, QRS complex should be less than 3 small squares if it is conducted through a regular pathway. Now we will see what happens in QRS complexes in chest leads V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. What you have to understand is the current is originated from the right side of the heart and it goes towards the from SA node to AV node, AV node to bundle. From the bundle, a small current is always, the first current is a very small current which is coming to the right ventricle. Then a larger current goes to the left side towards the left ventricle. If you see the current flow, you can see the V1 vector. V1 vector, what happens is a small current is coming towards the V1. So you get a very small R wave, initial positive deflection in the V1, and a larger current is going away from this vector, so towards the left side, so you get a deeper S wave. So a small current is coming towards this vector, V1 shows a small positive deflection, and a larger current is going away from the vector in V1, so you get a deeper negative section. Same thing happens in V6. V6 get a smaller current, initially goes away from the vector, that's why it initial wave is small Q, then a larger current coming towards the V6, that's why you get a larger R waves in V6. In between it follows, slowly the height of the R wave increases and the depth of the S wave decreases. So that is in QRS complex in chest leads. Now you see normal ECG, you already understood that AVR, usually all the complexes are negative because current is going away from the vector. 2, 3 AVF, 1 AVL, everywhere QRS complex is positive. And V1 to V6, you can see a small waves in small R wave in a V1, a deep S wave in V1. That is because of the current flow in the heart. Again, you can see the V6, there is a small S wave or small Q wave, small negative deflection in the V6 and large R wave in the V6. So this all because of the current flow. Now you can see a Q wave. Normally you don't see any Q wave in most of the leads, except in lead 3 you can see a prominent Q waves in lead 3, but other leads it is not seen. If you are seeing a very prominent Q wave in any of the leads, you have to suspect a myocardial infarction. Whenever there is a complete destruction of the myocardial tissue, there is a negative window there, there is a hole there, it will not produce any positive deflection, you get a negative wave, that is Q wave. So except in lead 3, wherever you see a Q wave, significant Q wave, you have to suspect a infarct. So whenever there is an infarct, it is become a negative electrical window, it will produce a negative wave. Now what is pathological Q wave? You can see a small Q waves in many leads, we have already discussed. Some of the leads you can see very small Q waves, but to tell the Q wave is significant, you should have 25% of the next QRS complex. The Q wave should be more than 25% of the following QRS wave, then amplitude, then only you can call it as a significant Q wave. Or Q wave duration should be more than 40 milliseconds or one small box. These two criteria is not there, you cannot tell the QRS, Q wave is significant. And the same change should be there two contiguous leads, like you should get the same Q wave in V1, V2 or V2, V3 or V3, V4 or V5, V6 or 2 and 3 or 3 and AVF. Like that, two contiguous leads you are getting changes, you can tell it as significant. And most simplest way to remember is the Q wave should be more than 25% of the following QRS complex. Now you can see this ECG, there is a significant Q wave in lead 2, lead 3, lead AVF. So 2, 3 AVF indicates inferior wall. So whenever there is a Q wave in inferior wall, that indicates a old myocardial infarction in the inferior wall. So it indicates old myocardial infarction in the inferior wall. Now you can see the, in this ECG, you can see Q wave in V1, V2, V3, they are anterior leads. So that indicates a previous myocardial infarction. Infarction has occurred. It may be a 1-day infarction or 2-day infarction, or it might have occurred in 3-4 weeks back. We don't know when it occurred, but that part is infarcted and it has produced, it is producing a negative window. So QS pattern, this is called as QS pattern. There is no R wave here. QS pattern with an ST elevation indicates, always indicates a recent MI. Now we will see what are the causes for poor R wave progression in the chest lead. We already understood that R wave should progress from V1 to V6. But there are some conditions you don't see this, R wave will not progress. The most important clinical condition where R wave is not progressed properly is old anterior myocardial infarction and dextrocardia. These are the two important things. But anybody who is having a thick chest wall, tension pneumothorax, left ventricular hypertrophy, left bundle branch block, lead displacement, all these things you can get poor R wave progression. But the classical two conditions which produces poor R wave progression from V1 to V6 is old anterior wall infarction and dextrocardia. You can see in this ECG poor R wave progression in V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 you are seeing some R wave, V6 you are seeing some R wave, but they are not proper amplitude. So poor R wave progression in this ECG indicates an old myocardial infarction. You are getting a QS pattern in V1, V2, V3, V4. There is mild ST elevation, there is T inversion. So there is, that is anterior wall MI, but it is already infarcted. Now we'll see what is the criteria by which we can diagnose LVH. We are talking about QRS complex. By QRS complex, we can tell whether the patient has got a left ventricular hypertrophy or not. You can see the negative waves in lead V1 and positive waves in lead V6. So S wave in lead V1 and R wave in V6. You calculate the number of squares. So for S wave in V1, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 into 5, 5 squares. So that itself will become 25. Total number of small squares in V1 and V6, V1 negative, V6 positive, that is, if it is more than 35 small squares, you should make a diagnosis of left ventricular hypertrophy by a ECG voltage criteria. This criteria is called as SL criteria. Criteria will tell you whether the patient has got LVH or not by ECG. Ideally, you have to do an echo to understand whether the patient has got LVH or not. But by ECG voltage criteria, you can make a diagnosis of LVH by adding the number of small squares in negative waves in V1, positive waves in V6. Now, this ECG simply tells you that this patient has got a left ventricular hypertrophy with strain pattern. So, a deep S wave in V1, large R wave in V6 with ST depression, T wave inversion, it will tell you that patient has got left ventricular hypertrophy. Now, with same type of criteria, you can diagnose even RVH, right ventricular hypertrophy. If there is a dominant R wave in V1, we already discussed that very, very small R wave in V1 is normally seen. But here you can see very, very dominant R wave in V1 and dominant S wave in V5, V6. Dominant R wave in V1 is more than 7 millimeter tall, or R by S ratio more than 1. That is a classical diagnostic criteria. Very tall R wave in V1 with R by S ratio more than 1, that is diagnostic criteria for RVH. Whatever it may be, if you are seeing a very good R wave in V1, make a diagnosis of RVH. Now, this ECG you can see very tall R wave in V1 with ST depression, T wave inversion V1, V2, V3. This indicates right ventricular hypertrophy. So, ECG criteria for RVH is very dominant R waves in V1. Now, we will see what happens if the QRS complex become wide. We have already discussed that the QRS complex width should be less than 3 small squares in ECG paper. So, if the QRS complex duration is more than 120 milliseconds or more than 3 small squares, you have to make a diagnosis of wide QRS complex. There are 3 important diagnoses for wide QRS complex. One is left bundle branch block, second one is right bundle branch block, third one is Wolff Parkinson White syndrome. You can see here there is a dominant S wave in V1, so deep wave S wave in V1, broad notched R wave in lateral leads like 1 AVL V5 V6. You are seeing a M pattern of QRS complex in V5 V6. Some patients you can see W pattern also. Whatever it is, there will be a notch in between the QRS complex. Following that, if the QRS complex is positive, you get an ST depression with T wave inversion. If you are getting an M pattern, you are getting a ST elevation, T wave upright. But classical finding is a M pattern in V5, V6. Following that ST depression, T wave inversion, this is called as left bundle branch block. Most of the time, left bundle branch block is clinically significant. It indicates ischemic heart disease. Patient may require evaluation for that. Acute LBBB indicates acute myocardial infarction. So, whatever it is, you can see here, there is a wide QRS complex more than 3 squares. So, this ECG shows a wide QRS complex. There is M pattern in V5, V6 for the QRS complex, which is wide. Following that, there is ST depression, but T wave is upright. This is called as concordant pattern. Previously we have seen discordant pattern. This we will discuss when we discuss about a left bundle branch block. But what you have to understand is wide QRS complex in V5, V6 with a notch in between always indicate left bundle branch block. Now we will see what is right bundle branch block. Again, if you are getting a wide QRS complex, that is a diagnostic feature of some bundle branch block. Here you have to see the V1. There is a broad QRS complex more than 120 milliseconds or more than 3 squares. There is a typical RSR dash pattern, small r, large s. There is a R dash, that means initially there is a small r, then a S wave, then a very large R dash pattern, that is second R. This is called as RS dash pattern, RSR dash pattern, that is seen in V1, V3. That again, it's a M-shaped QRS complex, a wide notched QRS complex with a ST depression, T wave inversion is significantly seen in V1, V2, V3. That is a classical finding you see in right bundle branch block. Right bundle branch block is mostly benign. Most of this patient will not have any problem, but some acute condition like pulmonary embolism and all, you can get right bundle branch block. Otherwise, most of the patients are stable. So, what you are seeing in this ECG is RSR dash pattern with ST depression, T wave inversion, V1, V2. So that is a clinical, we can make a diagnosis of right bundle branch block, RBBB. Now, the third thing where you get a wide QRS complex is WPW syndrome. You get a wide QRS complex. Classically, there are 3 important findings. There is a short PR interval, very significant short PR interval, classical finding. Then there is a wide QRS complex. On the upslope of the QRS complex, you are seeing a slurring that is called as delta wave. So, 3 important findings, short PR interval, a wide QRS complex, there is a delta wave. So, that is Wolff Parkinson White syndrome. That is an accessory pathway. The problem of WPW syndrome, anytime patient can develop a supraventricular tachycardia, wide complex tachycardia is common. Now, this is an ECG of short PR interval, wide QRS complex. There is a notch in the upsloping of the QRS complex. You can make a possible diagnosis of WPW syndrome. The classical finding you have to observe is very, very short PR interval, wide QRS complex. So, we have discussed about different abnormalities in the QRS complex, different waves of the QRS. Thank you.